Welcome to this morning on Asake Podcast, your daily dose of insightful conversation on current affairs, politics, and social issues. Please share and also follow us on social media at SiteZW. Now, stay tuned to today's episode.
A very good morning to you guys. Welcome to this morning on Asake. Today is a Tuesday, man. Quite cold. The sun is out here. We're back to our jackets. It's month end, man. Approaching month end. And June is fast approaching. And yeah. There's going to be a cold morning and also cold evenings. Good morning to you, Nosaka, this morning.
Good morning, Brighton, and good morning to our guests. Yeah, it's getting colder by the day. Quite a confusing weather because, you know, during the day, it's quite hot.
What's on my mind this morning is the issue of South African elections, man. I've been not shocked, but also surprised, man, how they are embracing their democracy. For me, that's all on my mind this week as they go to the polls on the 29th of May. Also, I love the media, how the media covered. It's been covering this election in South Africa. You know, they're so independent. Obviously, someone can say they're biased here and there, but as compared to where we are as Zimbabweans, the media in South Africa has done well, man, in terms of covering these elections, given MK the platform, EFF the platform, the ANC, the DA, everyone has been given the platform for debate, for discourse.
And Zuma as well, banned from contesting.
Going to parliament, yeah.
So, yeah, we wait and see what happens there. But I see we have Mandaza there. Good morning, Mandaza Douglas.
Good morning, Side. The long queues that we've seen them winding up in London, in Australia, in Canada, in America, all parts of the globe. The diasporan the expatriates or whatever they want to call them, being able to go and cast their votes, you know, peacefully at all their embassies there, which is something that us Zimbabweans, we so much envy, so much that we envy. But unfortunately, we've got people that don't want us to vote. People don't want us to have a say. But they're happy to be able to receive some of the remittances coming from these diasporan people, but they don't want them to contribute in terms of who they elect in their constituencies, which is a shame. And also what you're mentioning is that the coverage of the media in South Africa seems to be a little bit balanced as well, that all the other political parties are covered by most of these media organization compared to in our lovely Zimbabwe, where you actually find maybe just one out of the campaigning days that a main opposition party is going to be covered, or they'll only allow access to a small party that they know that is not going to affect them at all. That's something that we absolutely envy for Zimbabwe, to be able to give the broadcasting, especially to the radios and the rural areas, for small parties as well to have their say, to outlay some of their policies and what are they going to be voted for, something that hasn't happened in Zimbabwe for a very, very long time. I give back the mic.
Yeah, thanks so much, Mandaza Takas, for that. What's on your mind politically? South African elections, what's happening there? What's on your mind? What have you observed in terms of how they're covering elections, campaigns, manifestos, how the media is covering these elections? Good morning to you, Njabulo.
Good morning, Brighton and Nonhlanhla, and good morning to your listeners. Officially, South Africa is 70 political parties which are going to be on the ballot. You know, the issue of freedom. When you wake up every day, I think since the time they announced the I think it was in April when they did their final registration, SABC every day in the morning has been running programs inviting political parties. You know, they are very funny small political parties. Like there is a vendor political party that only I think it is 7 contestants. But we had to watch the smallest of the smallest political parties live on SABC being given the opportunity to come in and present their policies. We have other regional politicians like the Western Cape community, what. They were also given the opportunity to come and present their policies in a national broadcasting. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you so much, Anjabulo. You know, Brighton, I was surprised to see so many political parties in South Africa. I only knew of a few. And, you know, I was just thinking if they are called ANC projects or if they are accused of splitting votes.
Yeah, in Zimbabwe, you know, if you form a new party, if Brighton forms a new party, they become called a faction of this big faction and so on and so on. But South Africans, you know, I mean, they're small parties, they're called minority parties sometimes. And you see them coexisting with other parties. No one labels them to say it's a project, this is not a project. Even the media, the way they label, the way they call these leaders, with dignity, man, as compared to in Zimbabwe here. Anyway, let's move on to the next speaker. Good morning to Enzo.
Morning. Ama-election aphathwa kanjani ngendlela iSouth Africa ephatha ngayo ama-election. Yazi uzawuzizwa ukukhululekile la ungaphandle ukuthi hayi ngendlela abaphatha ngayo ama-election kuhle kakhulu, kuyabukeka, akulakuzwangu, akulakuthi uyisikhipha sayiphi i-political party kumbe usupporta iphi i-political party. Omunye la uyazenzela okwakhe ngalo, omunye la uyazenzela okwakhe ngale. I-SABC cover wonke amabandla, akulakhetha ukuthi le ngelikhumbi ngelincane. Kube sokuzoba lenkinga ekhona eZimbabwe mina engangiphathi kahle ukuthi nxa upresidenti kobulawayo akunamvume yokuthi linye ibandla likhampeni kobulawayo ngoba upresidenti kobulawayo. Kodwa lapha eSouth Africa kulamaphosta noma ese-KZN elinye ibandla uma lifuna ukukhampeni i-KZN liyakhampeni akalivalelwa, kuthiwa amaphoyisa ukuthi bayemisa umbukhe ukuze umkhankaso wabo. Kodwa eZimbabwe uyathola kusenzakala into ezinjengalezo. Ukhetho lweZimbabwe sometimes ugcina sokusiba longawathemba kanti uwinile mbe umuntu kawinanga. Manje eSouth Africa ma kunje so umuntu uma ewinile akula kukhuluma ngoba ukhethwa ngkhona layo kuhambe kahle bekhankase kahle, kungiyela omunye obamba omunye izandla ukuthi hayi unungakhankasi lapha ngwanamhla mnyange lapha. Ngiyabonga kakhulu.
Well, siyabonga lathi Ndlovu. Do you think that ANC will win this election? What are your predictions?
No, why are you putting me on the spot? But also, for me, it's been the issue of coalition. We spoke up last time about the issue of coalition. To say the issue of coalition governments. This election is going to be a tricky one because of us, the MK factor, a new party being formed there by Jacob Zuma, the former leader of the ANC. So there's the MK factor there. Again, EFF, again, the DA. So it's going to be, I think, coalition government by saying no one is going to get 50 plus one.
Well, let's hear from Munamato. Morning, Munamato.
Morning, Nonhlanhla. As you're looking at the media spec, South Africa has got over 200 radio stations, and it has got over 2,000 community radio stations. And when you listen to the broader spec of them, especially those that are in the front line, talking about Jacaranda, Metro FM, Kwezi, Kwenkwezi, all the other ones that are in the front line, when you look at how they have opened up in terms of the politics and how they have come in, allow the politicians to come in and ask open questions about where the country is going and what it entails when their political party come into the space, what it entails and asking those open questions. It's really something beautiful to note, not just on the SABC media platforms, but on the general mainstream media, the way that it has conducted itself. And even the smaller community radio stations. Now, in the community radio stations, there's something that has been going on that I think it's a very big lesson to learn in terms of communal conversation and engagement. If you go on to, there's a radio station that is based in Stellenbosch. It's called Colored Radio Station. So what basically they've been doing, communities are actually coming together despite of their political differences, despite of their social status, despite of their whatever, what you call opulence that they have in the community, whatever. But they are coming together and they are saying, okay, look, we are the situations where there are political parties that are coming from all different spaces. But before they can come, and before any of you can go into any spaces, into wherever they're campaigning, can we sit down as a community and talk about what we want so that we can analyze in the conversations or whoever they are bringing, and they can come to us, not us go to them. Thank you, Nonhlanhla. Thank you, Brighton.
Thanks so much, Munamato, for that this morning. Yeah, quite interesting what you're raising there. Good morning to you, Kayogas. What's on your mind this morning?
Good morning. I've been looking at artistic freedoms around elections. So in 2022, I actually observed in Kenya, looking at how artists are, how they are conducting themselves in terms of their ability to make art, to vote, and to be voted for. I also looked at the same in Zimbabwe last year, and I've been looking at South Africa from afar. So in 22, when I was observing in Kenya, you'd see the likes of Davido flying in to influence people's opinions and a lot of artists being used to influence people's opinions. Same with Zimbabwe, as we are now seeing that there are a lot of artists who are actually being awarded or rewarded for their efforts during the campaign season with CARS ETC. And so these artists were making content in order to get money or in order to get some form of recognition instead of being genuine opinion makers for ideologies that they believe in. So only artists who were already activists found a home in opposition political parties, especially in the case of our Zimbabwe scenario. So this has been a trend in Southern Africa, that if you were an activist, you then get into opposition politics. If you just wanted money and you just wanted to improve your livelihood, you'd end up just making content for that particular case. This has been different with South Africa. And to me, it's very interesting and fascinating to study, because most South African artists show some political consciousness. If someone is an artist, they already believe in EFF, they are going to continue campaigning for EFF in their social media pages without actually having those extra benefits that we are seeing in countries like Zimbabwe and Kenya. I've seen most TikTok influencers who have been excited around elections. Some of them were excited around the Umkhonto we're coming through. Some of them excited around EFF. Some of them maintaining the old and talking about ANC throughout. It was those influencers who already believed in that particular ideology and were campaigning for it, were then given gigs to push the particular political party. So this to me has been very interesting to study. And it's a lesson that we can take from South Africa, that we need to give young people the freedom to believe in what they believe in and to use their talents and their arts to push opinions towards what they believe in instead of doing things for money. Thank you so much for the opportunity.
Thank you so much, Tando, for that. Quite interesting what you are saying there. I love the issue that you're raising, the issue of artistic freedom. I would like to bring that issue to the issue to you have seen artists in South Africa performing at different rallies. Mm-hmm. And no one has been dragging them or insulting them. Unlike us in Zimbabwe, whereby if I perform today as Brighton, I go in MCs and appear for rally, I'm going to be labeled sellout. Mm-hmm. Whatever, I'm going to be labeled. If I go to CCC again, I'm going to be labeled whatever. Yeah, let's hear from Philip. Good morning to you, Philip.
Good morning. I'm an artist. I think I'm an artist. They are free to perform, but now Osia performer, I think you have to stay away from Irikalia. But the problem is when I lapa Zim, you'll find what the artist here hambie ko Irikalia. Then abantu sebenzisa what you do Brighton support, then that's where you start over lama enemies. But if you are but a hamba I performer get paid and just, you know, the problem is managing is what was supported. But South Africa, I know what other mafokate who support the ANC is open. And now if you by artists if you open, you are free to be open. Then abantu will understand where you stand. But my question for the topic is ufundeni to what we are seeing in South Africa. What have you learned from this election in South Africa? Utumeza imali every day, in a daily base, but you are not allowed to vote. What is the lesson? What are you taking from this? Because I'm a Zimbabwean, regardless whether it's MN or whatever, I'm not a second-class citizen.
Thank you so much, Bill, for that.
They dedicated 2 days to the diasporans in South Africa to vote. And that speaks volumes in terms of how they regard South Africans that are not in South Africa.
And there were many South Africans, men not in South Africa. I was thinking everyone in South Africa is going, is there because there's employment, everything is nice. But I saw many people out of the country and casting their votes. Come to the end of the show for this morning.
Yeah, it's been a great morning and we look forward to having you every other weekday from 8:30 to 9:30.
From myself, Brighton Ncube
and Nonhlanhla Mabikwa,
it's bye for now.
Thank you for tuning in to this episode. For feedback, you can contact us on 263-777-47-0017. Don't forget to follow and like our social media pages.